Hello, my name is Bob Mixa. Welcome to the Licensing Expert Series course on licensing Microsoft Windows Server 2012 R2. Let's first review our agenda. We will begin by looking at transformational IT trends that are occurring, and we'll identify some of the challenges that today's organizations face in light of these trends. We will then review the Windows Server 2012 R2 benefits and features and look at the additions. Then we will review licensing details and focus in on the exciting new licensing program for Microsoft, the server and cloud enrollment available through the enterprise agreement. We will look at a few scenarios, and after reviewing next steps, you will be afforded the opportunity to evaluate your knowledge through an assessment. Organizations today are facing new realities about how they operate based on trends, which include cloud computing, the consumerization of IT, the explosion of data, and the development of new social and app patterns. Let's take a closer look at each of these trends. First of all, companies are moving their workloads to the cloud at an ever-increasing pace. Cloud services offer a variety of software to help organizations work effectively, from office productivity like Office 365 to device management through Windows Intune. It's predicted that by 2016, cloud-hosted workloads will be 5 times what they are today, which equate to 2/3 of all workloads. Secondly, applications are rapidly being developed, and these too are cloud-enabled. Today, there are 1 billion Facebook accounts, 20 million Twitter accounts producing 400 million tweets a day, 10.4 million Pinterest accounts, and 160 million LinkedIn accounts. Then we have users bringing devices from home to work, and these users need IT support like corporate security. And compliance needs can't be sacrificed to meet these expectations. By 2014, it's projected that there will be 3.3 devices per worker. This has led to an explosion in social experiences in how we collaborate at work, whether in the office, at home, or mobile. This explosion is being powered by cloud services, which allow information to roam with us across devices. And as storage and data collection becomes less expensive, more data is being collected, with an increasing amount of it being streamed with the expectation that the data provides real-time analysis. Big data refers to the increasing volume, variety, and velocity of data, and industry analyst estimates that the amount of data will increase by 44 times in the next decade. And surprisingly, analysis indicates that 90% of the world's data has been created in the last 2 years. With these trends, the ensuing transformations underway, the traditional approaches to IT are no longer adequate, and organizations need a different approach. A different approach to acquiring software and services that supports these trends. And companies today need a unified strategy, a consistent platform, and a consistent licensing that helps them to navigate these trends. By delivering global scale services, Microsoft has been learning what is required from this new era of IT and has taken what has been learned together with the trends in technology innovations and built them into products and licensing to deliver and manage the modern platform, the Cloud OS. In order to enable the modern platform, the Cloud OS, organizations need products and licensing that are flexible, simplified, and cloud-enabled, tailored to meet the needs of today's organizations. Let's take a look at Microsoft Windows Server 2012 R2. When you optimize your business for the cloud with Windows Server 2012 R2, you take advantage of the skills and investment you've already made in building a familiar and consistent platform. Windows Server 2012 R2 builds on that familiarity. You gain all the Microsoft experience behind building and operating private and public clouds, delivered as an enterprise-class, simple and cost-effective server and cloud platform. Windows Server 2012 R2 delivers significant value around the following seven key capabilities. First of all, server virtualization platform that has helped organizations of all sizes realize considerable cost savings and operational efficiency. With industry-leading size and scale, Hyper-V is the platform of choice for you to run your mission-critical workloads. This release greatly expands support for host processor and memory, and you can take advantage of new hardware technology while still utilizing the servers you already have. This way, you can virtualize today and be ready for the future. Secondly, with this release, there was a strong focus on storage from the foundation of the storage stack up, with improvements ranging from provisioning storage to how data is clustered, transferred across the network, and ultimately accessed and managed. Three, networking with Windows Server 2012 R2 makes it straightforward to manage an entire network as a single server, giving you the reliability and scalability of multiple servers at a lower cost. Four, server management and automation that enables IT professionals to meet the need for fast, continuous, and reliable services within their data centers by offering an integrated platform to automate and manage the increasing data center ecosystem. Fifth, web and application platform products on the tradition of the Windows Server family as a proven application platform with thousands of applications already built and deployed and a community of millions of knowledgeable and skilled developers already in place. Sixth is access and information protection, so you'll be able to better manage and protect your data access, simplify deployment and management of your identity infrastructure on premises and across clouds, and provide your users with more secure remote access to application data from virtually anywhere and any device. And lastly and finally, virtual desktop infrastructure is even easier to deploy and deliver across workers' devices, since VDI technology in this release offer easy access to a rich, full fidelity Windows environments running in the data center from virtually any device. With the latest release, Windows Server 2012 R2, Microsoft is providing enterprise-class performance and scale for Microsoft workloads that is simple and cost-effective, application-focused, and user-centric. Now, on servers that are not expected to be highly virtualized, Windows Server Standard is still the optimal addition, and with an ability to assign multiple licenses to a single server to increase the allowed virtual densities on that server. Keep in mind that servers licensed with Windows Server Standard will need to have the appropriate number of licenses assigned to that server to ensure coverage of all the virtual OSEs that are running at any given time. Let's begin by reviewing the additions of Windows Server. For those familiar with the prior editions of Windows Server 2008 R2, you will recognize Data Center, Enterprise, and Standard editions shown here. This licensing model provided flexibility by offering a variety of additions and features. Data Center offered a per-processor licensing model with all available features and unlimited virtualization, while Enterprise Edition was available as a server license that permitted up to four virtual instances and offered some advanced features. Standard Edition was available as a server license, had limited features, and provided for one virtual instance. With today's simplified model, customers can select the edition of Windows Server 2012 based on the specific virtualization needs while still having access to the same features across both editions. For high density virtualization, Data Center is ideal. For low density or no virtualization environments, Standard is ideal. Windows Server 2012 R2 is available in four editions designed to suit a variety of customers' needs. Data Center and Standards are ideal for private cloud, while Essentials and Foundations are optimal for small businesses. Windows Server 2012 R2 data center will continue to be the ideal addition for highly virtualized private and hybrid cloud environments, providing customers with unlimited virtualization rights and all of the enhanced and new features of Windows Server 2012. The licensing for data center will continue to follow a processor plus CAL model. However, now each license will cover up to two physical processors on a server. Windows Server 2012 R2 standard is ideal for physical computing or lightly virtualized environments, providing customers with an additional virtual instance than the previous version, for a total of two virtual instances along with all of the same features as Data Center Edition. The licensing for standard is now the same as Data Center with a processor plus CAL model, with each licensing covering up to two physical processors on a server. Windows Server 2012 R2 Essentials is a cloud-connected first server ideal for small businesses with up to 25 users, providing customers with the flexibility to have email in the cloud, runtime of business applications, or run email on-premises. The licensing for Essentials will continue to be a server model with no CAL requirements. And finally, Windows Server 2012 R2 Foundation is an economical, general-purpose server for physical computing environments only. It provides customers with a Windows Server experience for up to 15 users. The licensing for Foundation will continue to be a server model with no CAL requirements. Windows Server 2012 Core Editions, Data Center, and Standard are both private cloud optimized solutions, providing all of the same features and capabilities and cost-effective virtualization options. Data Center is ideal for highly virtualized environments, and it provides for unlimited virtualization. This edition is ideally suited for rapidly growing businesses with high-density virtualization needs. Standard Edition is optimal for low-density environments or for those without virtualization needs, as each license provides for two virtual instances. Both Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center and Standard Editions are only differentiated by virtualization rights. Data Center provides for unlimited virtualization, and Standard provides customers with two virtual instances with each license. Both editions share a common licensing structure based on a processor plus CAL model, where each license will cover up to two physical processors on a single server. There is no difference in the available features of these two editions, since Standard Edition now has all of the same features that were previously only available in the Data Center Edition. Now let's take a closer look at licensing. All editions of Windows Server 2012 R2 provide flexible, simple, and cost-effective licensing options with greater value tailored to meet the growing demands of IT today and in the future. Flexible licensing facilitates buying and managing licenses easily for both on-premises and cloud. A simplified licensing model helps streamline assignment and management of licenses, and cost-effective solutions provide organizations with options that can be customized based on usage. Let's look at licensing the new editions of Windows Server 2012 R2. The table provides a licensing overview where both Data Center and Standard Edition share a common licensing model, with each license covering up to two processors and requiring a CAL or client access license for any user or devices that accesses an instance of the server software. Again, these two models are optimized for cloud computing. Essentials and Foundation editions are server licenses. Essential covers up to two processors, and Foundation covers one processor. Again, these models are ideally suited for small businesses. It's important to note that every user or device that accesses an instance of Windows Server 2012 R2 requires a CAL or client access license, which are designed to be used exclusively with a particular server. There are two types of CALs, device and user CALs. Customers can select the most economical CAL based on their particular scenario. A device CAL is an access license required for every device used by any user. Device CALs are most appropriate for customers with multiple users accessing an instance of Windows Server on a single device, such as shift workers. While a user CAL, which is an access license required for every named user accessing the server from any device, is the most appropriate for a customer with many roaming employees who need access to the corporate network from unknown devices and/or employees who access the network via multiple devices. When considering whether to purchase devices or user CALs, if the number of users that will access an instance of Windows servers is less than the number of devices, then it is more economical choice to select user CALs. There are also two licensing modes for CALs. First is the per user or per device mode, which is determined by the number of users or devices accessing the server software, where the number of servers accessed does not matter. And the second is in the per server mode, which is determined by the maximum number of users or devices that may simultaneously access or use the server software running on a particular server. We have adopted the same model as System Center 2012, creating a consistent licensing experience across our private cloud. Both System Center 2012 and Windows Server 2012 are available in two editions: Standard for non-virtualized or lightly virtualized environments, and Data Center for highly virtualized environments. They both have the same licensing model, a processor license that covers up to two physical processors on a server, and both editions of products have the same capabilities. Once again, the only differentiator between the editions will be the virtualization rights. Standard edition provides two virtual instances with each license, and Data Center, again, offers unlimited virtualization with each license. Both Windows Server 2012 R2 Data Center and Standard Editions include several improvements to their capabilities and licensing. While with Windows Server 2008 R2, Data Center and Standard Editions had different capabilities, Windows Server 2012 R2 Editions both share the same improvements in capability. Both editions benefit from the same increased processor support and memory and other features, and again, are only differentiated by virtualization rights, offering the same premium feature set to both Standard and Data Center licenses. Customers are able to downgrade their bits to a previous version or edition of Windows Server. As always, customers that have Data Center Edition will be able to downgrade to any previous version or edition. Customers with Windows Server 2012 Standard Edition can downgrade to any previous edition of Standard, Enterprise, or Essentials. Customers with Windows Server 2012 Data Center can downgrade to any previous version of any edition. It is important to remember that downgrade rights allows a customer to downgrade the bits only, but the license rules of the purchase version still apply. For example, if a customer wants to downgrade from Windows Server 2012 Standard Edition to Windows Server 2008 R2 Enterprise Edition, they can run the Enterprise bits. However, the license will still cover two processors and allow for two virtual instances. The bits for Windows Server 2008 R2 are available for download on the Volume Licensing Service Center site. Other bits for other versions are not available. Now let's take a look at the options that are available to customers who need to closely manage their growth. Customers can increase or grow their virtualization instances in two ways. For those customers that want to have a highly virtualized environment, they can choose to assign multiple Standard Edition licenses to a single server, often referred to as stacking licenses. While each standard license they assign to a server, a customer will be able to increase their virtualization rights by two. This ensures a constant price per instance and controlled budgeted growth. Or customers with active software assurance that want to move towards a highly virtualized environment can use their step-up benefit to move from Standard Edition to Data Center Edition, receiving a price advantage over purchasing the data center license without using the step-up benefit. Customers should remember that they can only step up one license for one license. If a customer knows that they will eventually have a highly virtualized environment, they should consider moving to Data Center Edition instead of stacking standard licenses in the short term. This will enable them to grow as quickly as they need without having to purchase additional licenses and without having additional standard licenses remaining when they're ready to step up to Data Center. It's important to note that the Software Assurance Step-Up Benefit only allows the exchange of one license for one license. A customer who wants to step up from an existing standard license can only step up to one standard for one data center. Now let's talk about the server and cloud enrollment. Earlier, we looked at transformational trends and talked about Microsoft empowering customers by simplifying the licensing process and by delivering a licensing platform that supports the cloud OS model. The server and cloud enrollment is a new licensing vehicle under the enterprise agreement, which enables customers to standardize on one or more Microsoft server and cloud technology and provides significant advantages. The SCE is a fully cloud-enabled licensing vehicle that gives customers the best licensing management and the most flexibility to manage your own data centers and move to the cloud. SCE is a great licensing vehicle for standardization on Microsoft platform technology and provides customers with the best pricing, terms, and benefits. SCE offers our lowest Windows Azure pricing, application license mobility to the cloud, and new benefits for using System Center to manage Windows Azure resources. SCE also includes a new subscription-based option which offers more flexibility when retiring workloads, consolidating, or migrating to the cloud. Customers can take advantage of simplified licensing through a standardized set of SKUs and gain access to the latest technologies and benefits for all deployments. SCE offers Microsoft's best pricing and benefits for server and cloud products, including discounts on new licenses, software assurance, and Windows Azure. Eligible customers may also qualify for premium benefits like unlimited support. Let's look at a comparison between our previous enrollments under the EA and the new enrollment landscape with SCE. Microsoft has simplified the enrollment landscape under the EA to support the cloud OS. Previously under the EA, customers could take advantage of three enrollments beyond their enterprise-wide desktop commitment. These were the enrollment for Application Platform, the enrollment for Core Infrastructure, and the enrollment for Windows Azure. As a quick recap, the enterprise enrollment is where customers make installed base-wide commitments to Windows Client, Office, the Core Cal, and eCal in return for a discount of 15% off the license and software assurance SKUs, 5% off SA SKUs, and other benefits. This remains unchanged in the new enrollment landscape. The enrollment for Application Platform, or EAP, allowed customers to make a commitment to SQL Server and/or development tools, for example. Customers making that commitment did not receive discounts on SA, but they did get extra discounts on new units of licenses and SA. Those discounts were complicated, providing 15% off part of SKUs for standard products and 40% off part of SKUs for premium products. The enrollment for Core Infrastructure, or ECI, for commitment to 25 licenses offered access to Windows Server plus System Center through a SKU called the Core Infrastructure Suite, or CIS. It provided a 20% discount over cost of standalones, both for new units and for software assurance. Enrollment for Windows Azure, or EWA, was a vehicle for customers to gain access to the enterprise portal and include Windows Azure in their EA. The previous landscape had varying terms, varying conditions, and varying commitment requirements. In comparison, the new landscape is simplified with the server and cloud enrollment, which replaces the EAP, the ECI, and the EWA, creating a much more streamlined and simplified set of options for customers. As we move to the server and cloud, we're going to offer our customers the option to make install base-wide commitments to core products that exist within the SCE in return for a series of benefits. For customers that have been buying Windows Server and System Center through ECI and not making install base-wide commitments, we now have those core infrastructure suite SKUs available in our other programs, in Select, in the Enterprise Enrollment as an additional product, and that SKU is a great SKU for customers to take advantage of when they're buying transactionally. Now, SCE is a 3-year commitment under an EA. In addition to SCE benefits, customers also receive EA benefits such as volume discounts. While a server and cloud enrollment can be started at any time, the SCE is available as a renewal for existing EAP and ECI customers. For customers with an expiring EA or SA commitment, it is a great time to evaluate whether SCE is the right licensing vehicle for your server and cloud needs. To enroll in an SCE, an install-based wide commitment is required to one or more of the 4 following SCE components. The first is core infrastructure, then application platform. Third is developer platform, and fourth, Windows Azure. Choose any of these components individually or group them as needed. When choosing any of the first 3 components, Windows Azure at its best pricing is also available. This means committing to full software assurance coverage across the installed base of an SCE component. In the case of System Center, a commitment is required to full System Center coverage on the Windows Server install base through the core infrastructure suites. In return for making this commitment, the SCE offers a range of benefits, including a new cloud-optimized licensing options, simplified licensing management, and the best pricing and terms. Minimum quantities apply for CIS SKUs for the entire Windows install base. Existing deployments without software assurance are added as subscription or LNSA at signing. SCE is an evolution of the EAP. There are a few changes, and customers should renew their EAP agreement in SCE. They will experience continuity in many respects, but will also gain positive new benefits, including the ability to easily start using Windows Azure, flexibility to retire workloads at any time, and new subscription option and easier to understand standardized discounts. There will be more changes for ECI customers and SCE and will not be a good fit for all. The primary change is that customers will be required to make an install-based wide commitment to CIS, which was not required with ECI. In exchange, customers will get all of the new SCE benefits. Now let's take a look at the Windows Server 2012 editions that are ideal for small businesses essential, which is Essentials and the Foundation editions. For the small business market, Microsoft continues to offer the same licensing and pricing model for Essentials and Foundation editions. The Windows Small Business 2011 Essentials is now Windows Server 2012 Essentials. Essentials continues to be the ideal first server for a small business packed with new features and capabilities targeted for the small businesses. The licensing model continues to be a per server model limited to 2 processors and a 25 user account limit and a 50 device limit. The Essentials servers does not provide rights to host any virtual instances but can be virtualized, meaning that the license offers the options to either run the instance in a physical environment or in a virtual environment, but not both. Foundation Edition is also available through the OEM channel and is a general purpose server. With the release of Windows Server 2012, there are no changes to the licensing model of Foundation. Foundation Edition offers a server license, and each license is limited to covering processor or PROC. Foundation also has 15 user account limit and does not provide any virtualization rights. One license permits one instance to be run in the physical operating system environment. Windows Server 2012 R2 Essentials is the ideal solution for customers who previously ordered either Small Business Server 2011 Essentials or Small Business 2011 Standard. Customers who previously relied on SBS 2011 Essentials to leverage cloud computing for applications and messaging and collaboration services can now rely on Windows Server 2012 R2 Essentials and other Microsoft solutions such as Office 365, Hosted Exchange, and other online apps and services as well. Customers who previously purchased SBS 2011 Standard can now leverage cloud-based apps and services with Windows Server 2012 R2 Essentials and other Microsoft solutions and online apps and services. As with Data Center and Standard Edition, customers will also be able to continue to downgrade their bits to a previous version or edition of Windows Server. Customers with Windows Server 2012 Standard Edition customers will be able to downgrade to a previous version of Standard or new with this release, Enterprise Edition. And customers with Windows Server 2012 Essentials will be able to downgrade their bits to any previous version of Essentials. Now let's look at Microsoft's payment solutions. Microsoft offers a range of flexible payment options which are helpful to customers who are either structuring their new SC agreement or renewing. Depending on the specific needs, customers can take full advantage of Microsoft payment solutions in a number of ways to manage their cash flow more strategically and alleviate the need of making a large upfront annual investment. Microsoft Payment Solutions offers deferred payments for up to 6 months. So if you are interested in SCE today but do not have adequate funds left in this year's budget, you can defer payment until the next fiscal year when more funds are available. You get the technology you need today even if you're unable to fully fund it in the current fiscal year. SCE requires that 3 equal payments be made each year, but this may not align well to your investment and cash flow needs. With Microsoft Payment Solutions, you can ramp payments over the term of the SCE, paying, for example, 10% of the entire 3-year SCE investment in year 1 when funds are needed for other projects, 30% in year 2, and 60% in year 3 when more funds are available. Alternatively, customers may wish to avoid having to make a large upfront payment each year and would rather utilize cash as it becomes available each month. With Microsoft Payment Solutions, customers can spread their annual payments into equal monthly payments over the term of the SCE. Now let's review a few customer scenarios. A customer with a highly virtualized data center is interested in standardizing their core infrastructure. Which volume licensing program best fits this customer scenario? The solution? The server and cloud enrollment in the enterprise agreement. A Windows Server 2012 R2 customer needs flexibility to accommodate increased virtualization needs in the future, but is not expecting the growth to be rapid. Which option is available with which addition that will help achieve these goals? The customer can choose to purchase Windows Server 2012 R2 standard licenses to take advantage of stacking licenses to increase virtualization instances. A customer with an expiring EAP would like to renew into SCE. What is required for the customer to do so? The customer must commit to full software assurance coverage across the installed base of the SCE component. In the case of System Center, for an EAP customer, a commitment is required to full System Center coverage on the Windows Server install base through the Core Infrastructure Suites, or CIS. A customer with over 250 PCs is interested in standardizing organization-wide on the Microsoft application platform. Which Microsoft volume licensing program and licensing vehicle provides the best pricing and additional benefits for this customer? Your solution, the enterprise agreement and the server and cloud enrollment. Now that you've completed the course, take the associate exam to test your knowledge. I want to thank you for your time and attention to this course today, and bye for now.